Hello students, in the last class we discuss about the microsporogenesis. In that we discuss about interesting topics of Wollongrins. Now we can discuss about the female sex organ, that is the carpel or a pistil. Carpel or pistil is a female sex organ. Okay, in case of unisexual flower, the flower which have only female sex organ, that is called as a pistillate flower. Pistillate flower means a unisexual flower which have only female sex organ, that is a carpel or pistil. Okay, female sex organ carpel, a group of carpels is called as a gynoecium. We already discussed a group of carpels or the pistils are called as a gynoecium. ಭಾಳಷ್ಟು ಕಾರ್ಪೆಲ್ಸು ಮತ್ತು ಪಿಸ್ಟಿಲ್ನ ಸೇರಿಸಿ ನಾವೇನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ದಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಗೈನೋಶಿಯಂ. ಗೈನೋಶಿಯಂ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಲವರ್. ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅದು ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ಸೆಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ಪೆಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಪೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೇರಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್. ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದೆ group of carpel is called as a gynoecium, like a number of carpels are depends on the species. Okay, in some plants you can see the single pistil is present, those flowers are called as a monocarpellary. If only one carpel is present in that flower or plant, those species are called as a monocarpellary. Monocarpellary means those are the plants which have only one carpel in their flower. Carpel adru use madabodu athwa pistil adru word ana you can use. Second, in some plants the number of carpels are more. If the pistils or carpels are more, we can use the word multicarpellary. Monocarpellary means only one carpel is present. Multicarpellary means multi means more carpels are present. You can say two or three carpels are present. You can see the pentacarpellary, tetracarpellary, tricarpellary. Common aagi nanu use madid word only multicarpellary. Okay, these are the basic concepts of a female's reproductive part. Next, in some plants you can see the pistils are fused in condition. The group of pistils or carpels are called as a gynoecium when all the carpels or a gynoecium is fused. Such condition is called as a syncarpous condition. Carpels are fused. You can use carpels here also. Okay, when carpels or pistils are fused, such condition is called as a syncarpus. Syn means fused. Okay, in some plants you can see the carpels are free, they are individual, they are not fused. Such condition is called as a apocarpus condition. Syncarpus and apocarpus. Apo means free, syn means fused. Apocarpus and syncarpus condition. Okay, these are the very important: monocarpellary, multicarpellary, apocarpus and syncarpus. Syn means fused, apo means free. Next, it is very important, carpel or pistil have three important parts. More important parts, those are the stigma, style and the ovary. Stigma, style and The diagram of fistil is very clear in your NCERT book. You can see the structure of the carpel. It have the stigma, style and the ovary. Okay, the whole carpel which is attached with the thalamus of the flower. It is the receptacle of the flower. Okay, the first part, that is the stigma. Second one, style and the ovary. Stigma, style and ovary are the parts of the carpel, that is a female sex organ. Okay, stigma is a flat form for receiving the pollen grains or landing the pollen grains. It is usually different in structure. You can see the varieties of structures in the stigma. In some stigmas are branched, some stigmas are dumbbell shape, some stigmas are star shape. You can see the varieties of shapes in a stigma. Okay, basically the function of the stigma is to diffuse the pollen grains. Stigma do function in antandra, must and should it receives the pollen grains. Okay, then style is a long and a slender structure. Long and slender structure. Okay, below the stigma. Stigma kinta kelagade irutta, it has the long and a slender structure. Okay, later the third part of the female sex organ, it is swollen part of the carpel, is called as a ovary. Style is a long slender structure. It ends with a basal swollen structure called as a ovary. This is the structure of female sex organ, that is a carpel. You can see here after the structure of carpel, this is the diagram for a multicarpellary and a syncarpous condition. Multicarpellary and a syncarpous condition. Here, this is the diagram of Papaveraceae family species. You can see the stigmas here. The 2 and 3 stigmas are fused in conditions. Sorry, 2 and 3 carpels are fused in condition. You can see a multicarpellary. This is one carpel, second carpel, third and fourth, fifth, sixth. Six carpels are fused in condition in a Papaveraceae family plants. This is the example. This is a diagram of a multicarpellary and syncarpus. Bhalastu carpels though, but those are fused in condition. That is called as a multicarpellary syncarpus condition. Example, you can give the Papaveraceae or Papaverae. Next, you can see the diagram of multicarpellary apocarpus species. Okay, here you can see the mango shaped structure. Here those are the carpels, which are not fused. Many carpels are present, hardest carpels though, but those are not fused. Those are independent, they are not attached, they are not attached or not fused. Such condition is called as a apocarpus condition. Apocarpus condition. This is a example for multicarpellary apocarpus. Bahalastu carpels irudrinda, you can say multicarpellary. The carpels are free in condition, though that's why it is called as an apocarpus. Example, you can give Michaelia champaka. Michaelia means mallige. Okay, Michaelia champaka, that is a example for multicarpellary apocarpus condition. You can see, I wrote like that only. Stigmas is the landing platform for the pollen grains. Style is elongated slender part below the stigma, okay, which supports the stigma. Basal swollen part of the pistil is called as a ovary. Ovary is a swollen part which is present below the style, okay. Ovary have the, it is usually swollen, ovary have the cavity called as a ovarian cavity. It is also called as a locule, okay. Inside that cavity or a locule, you can see the ovules are present. Ovules are nothing but the megasporangium. Yav tara niv anther olagade microsporangium anna nodiddi, same ade tara ovary olaga you can see the megasporangium or the ovules which are present in a locule. Okay, next point. The pattern of arrangement of ovules in a locule is called as a placentation. We can discuss with a diagram. A number of ovules in a ovary may vary from one species to other species, species to species or a other species. You can see here, this is a stigma. I am drawing the diagram of carpel. This is a style and this one is a ovary. Just I will use the shortcuts. Stigma, style and a ovary. Okay. These are the, they are not usually important. The important megasporangium is present in a ovary. Okay, when we take the section of ovary, now ovules matha locules anna nodbekandre we have to take the section of ovary. Idanna TS tagdaga you can get the structure like this. When we take the TS, you can get the structure, circular structure which have the ovarian cavity. Ovarian cavity anta helidvi, those are having the chamber like structures like this. Ovarian cavity have the chambers. The one chamber is separated from another chamber. I am using the double lines for separation of chambers. One chamber in the inner chamber separated though. Okay. These chambers, those are the locules. The ovary have the ovarian cavity. That cavity is called as a locule. There are so many locules are present in a ovary, it depends. Tetralocular, pentalocular, monolocular, bilocular, trilocular. If locule is one, monolocular. Two locule, monolocular. Two locules, bilocular. Three locules, trilocular. Like this, pentalocular, hexahepta, multilocular you can say. Locule is a chamber or ovarian cavity where the ovules are present. Athrolagade, I will use the green color, ovules. Just I am drawing the single ovule. The ovules are present in a locule, okay. The pattern of arrangement of a ovule and a locule is called as a placentation. Yav tara pattern olagade ovules locule olagade arrange agirta pattern anna nave en heltivi, placentation. rotation. It is a arrangement of a ovules in a locule is called as a placentation. You can see the varieties of placentation, usually 6 types of placentation: exile, parietal, free central, like this. You have to study all these things in a practical. Okay, here just understand the pattern of arrangement of a ovules in a locule. Ovules so locule olage arrange agiro pattern ge navu en heltivi placentation. For example, this is the pattern of exile placentation. Suppose ide enadru bere tara placentation yav tara possibility antandra, just a rough diagram I am drawing here. These are the locules. You can see the presence of ovule like this also. Margin igenadru attach agidra, that is a different pattern of arrangement. This is a different placentation. This is all about the ovary. Okay, we have to study the ovule. Now idru mele focus madbekagirudu yadru mele andra, the small structure which is present in the ovary, in a ovarian cavity or the locule, that is a ovule, ovule or a megasporangium. Yav tara microsporangium karithivo adar tara megasporangium. Megasporangium. The ovules or a megasporangium is attached with a small structure called a stalk. ಓಕೆ ಈ ಥರ ಯಾವುದೇ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೂ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರಿಂದ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಫ್ಯೂನಿಕಲ್, ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಫ್ಯೂನಿಕಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಮೆಗಾಸ್ಪೊರಾಂಜಿಯಂ. ಮೆಗಾಸ್ಪೊರಾಂಜಿಯಂ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದ ಓವ್ಯೂಲ್. ಮೆಗಾಸ್ಪೊರಾಂಜಿಯಂ ಆರ್ ಅ ಓವ್ಯೂಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ attached with the placenta of a ovary by means of stalk like structure called as a funicle. Okay, then the funicle is a stalk like structure where the ovule is attached with the ovarian cavity, that is the placenta. Okay, then hilum is the structure where the both the ovules and the funicles are attached. Yelli now itara structure nodidvi, this is a placenta, here the ovule is attached, the stalk like structure is called as a funicle. Okay, the where the portion the ovule, this is a ovule and this is a funicle, the point where both are attached, that is called as a hilum. Okay, funicle and a hilum. Hilum is a where both the ovules and the funicles are attached. Next, ovule have 2 or 3 protective layers. Detail olagade ovule structure na study madbekandra, this is the structure of a ovule. You can see here, nan ill draw maadi heltini nimgade, this is the small locule. Nan enavagle circle tagondiddnella adrolagade ondu small portion, a small portion olagade you can see the stalk like structure, this is a funicle and which is attached with the ovule. Where the ovule and funicle attach, that is called as a hilum. Okay, ide structure na now inverted position olage ee tara nodabodu, ovule which have the stalk like structure called as a funicle, the funicle and a ovule attach, that structure is called as a hilum. Okay, then ovule or a megasporangium have a protective layers. You can see the protective layers are the outer integument and inner integument. Integuments are nothing but the protective envelopes or protective layers. Okay, outermost layer ge na outer integument anta karitivi, innermost layer ge na inner integument anta karitivi. You can see here both the integuments are not covers whole ovule or whole structure of, they are not continuous, means inside the ovule important structure is present, that is the embryo sac or a female gametophyte. A ovule olagade you can see the female gametophyte or a embryo sac. Okay, the integuments which surrounds the embryo sac except a small opening or a small interruptions is called as a micropore. Embryo sac sutta integuments iruttha except a small opening. One kade matra eradu integuments absent irthavu, that absent portion is called as a micropylar pole. Micropyle anta usually karithivi navu. Okay, the integuments which covers the whole embryo sac except a small opening called as a micropylar pole or micropyle end. Next, outer integument, inner integument, innermost layer which is just surrounding the embryo sac. Here you can see, which I am drawing with a blue color pen, it is very important. Okay, this layer is outer integument, this one is a inner integument. Okay, another layer which I am drawn with the blue color, sorry, this whole blue color which just surrounds the embryo sac, that layer is called as a nucellus layer. Nucellus is a protective layer which protects the developing embryo sac. Okay, and nucellus is a abundant in reserve food materials means it is a food for the developing embryo sac. It serves a food to the embryo sac. This is the structure of ovule. In your exam they will ask the diagram of ovule. You have to draw the structure. Inside the ovule you can see the embryo sac which is just covered by the nucellus. Nucellus is rich in nutrients or reserve food materials which gives a nutrition to the developing embryo sac. Then after the nucellus you can see the inner integument which is protective in nature. Later you can see the outer integument. Okay, the inner integument and outer integument, they are not continuous, they are not present in a small opening structure called as a micropyle or a micropylar end. Okay, the ovule which is attached with the placenta by the funicle, the fair funicle and a ovule is attached, that structure is called as a hilum. Okay, where in the ovule the small opening is present, by the absence of outer and inner integument, that end is called as a micropylar end. Ikkada end ana na micropylar end anta karithivi. Then where the presence of both the integuments opposite to the micropylar end, that end is called as a chalazal end or a chalazal pole. Pole antadru karibodu, end antadru helbodu. Micropylar end and a chalazal end. Okay, this is the structure of ovule. It is very important. They will ask for a 5 marks. It is very important. Draw the diagram of ovule and explain it neatly. Okay. I hope all of you getting this point. Inside the ovary, you can see the locule. Inside the locule, the presence of a ovule. Inside the ovule, you can see the embryo sac. Embryo sac is protected by the 3 layers, like a nucleus, outer integument, inner integument, and the structure have small opening called a micropylarate. Opposite to the micropylarate, you can see the chalazolin, the stalk-like structure which ovule is attached to the placenta, that is called as a funicle. Then the point where funicles and ovules are attached, the structure is called as a hilum. It is very important. Remember this diagram and practice this diagram, and remember all the explanation of this megasporangium or a ovule. This diagram is a anatropous ovule. You can see the 6 types of ovules, but in your NCERT book, this is a diagram of anatropous ovule. Here you can see the funicle, hilum, micropylarate and chalazolin in a straight line. You nalkuna now straight line olagade nodabodu. See here, this is a diagram of anatropous, inverted position, itara. Itandra, that is the anatropous ovule structure. Okay, remember the structure and remember the structure of nucleus and the function. Nucleus is very important. It is the protective plus nutritive layer which have the abundant reserve food materials, which serves the reserve food material to the developing embryo sac. Notes, here you can see the notes. Here hilum, where both the ovules and funicles are attached. Next point, ovule have in some cases you can see the 3 protective layers, outer, middle and inner integument. Usually you can see the 2 integuments, outer and inner integuments. 3 protective layers, those are integuments. Integuments are the covers whole the ovule except tip, where small opening is present, that is called as a micropyle. Where the micropyle is present, that end is called as a micropylar end. Okay, next, opposite end of a micropyle is called as a chalazal end. Opposite end of a micropyle is called as a chalazal end. Okay, it is a basal part. Next, a female gametophyte or a embryo sac, we can discuss in the next class what is embryo sac. Just remember, embryo sac is nothing but the female gametophyte. Pollen grain is nothing but the male gametophyte. Female gametophyte, that is the embryo sac, which is present inside the ovule, which is surrounded by a 1 nutritive tissue called a nucleus. You see, it is very important. It will come for 1 mark or 2 marks. Nucleus is rich in a reserve food materials, okay, which serves the nutrition to developing embryo cell. Okay, then ovule having the embryo sac, by means ovule which have the embryo sac is made by the reductional division of a megaspore. Okay, we can discuss this point in a next class, that is a megasporogenesis. How the megaspore is developed. Megaspore is nothing but the ovule, ovule is nothing but the megasporangium. Inside the megasporangium, embryo sac is present. Embryo sac is made by the reductional division or a meiosis by the megaspores. Means megasporangium have many megaspores. So you can see the embryo sac in a ovule, which have the female gamete. We can discuss Megaspora and Gemina next class. Hello students, in the last class we discussed about the microsporogenesis. In that we discussed about formation of a microspores by the meiosis cell division. Inside the engantho, those are the sporogenous tissues are present. They undergoes through the meiosis division to form a dyad. Dyad again undergoes through the meiosis second to form a pollen tetrad. Later was that pollen tetrad arranged in a cluster form. Then later was dehydration takes place inside the anther. The cluster of pollen grains are get separated and to form a separate individual pollen grains. After separating from the cluster, the independent pollen grains are having the two covering layers, exine and the intine. The exine is outermost layer, intine is a innermost layer. Exine is made up of a sporopollen, intine is made up of a cellulose and pectin. Today, then